song, The Arms of the One Who Loves You by Escape. And I'm going to go through just the first two verses of the song in hopes that I can share with you this on-time prophetic word that is from the mouth and the heart of God for you. And so the song starts out and it says, I know you're going, I can't make you stay. There's a story in the Bible, when the story is often taught, the emphasis is on the prodigal son. But it's interesting to me that the story begins by saying there was a man who had two sons. And so I would argue that the story is more about the man as opposed to the two sons in the story, though they play a significant part. I believe when Jesus was sharing the story, it was because he wanted to share the heart and the character of God. You know, there are a lot of reasons why we leave from God, why we stop trying to pursue a relationship with him. Some of us, our experiences in church. Some of us, our experiences in our family. You know, if you saw your family members act one way at church and another way at home, that could have affected you. You know, maybe you experienced disappointment. Maybe you feel like what you learned about God didn't pan out the way it was supposed to, and you felt disappointed, and so you decided to leave him. I love how Jesus asks the disciples, those who were close to him, he first says, who do men say that I am? And they gave him a lot of different things that he was: Elijah, John the Baptist, one of the prophets, somebody from the dead. And then he said, well, who do you say that I am? Because it's a lot of people that said a whole lot of stuff about him. But who do you say he is? Have you spent time to get to know him on your own? Have you spent time asking him questions and letting him answer? And so here in the story, it starts out, it says there was a man who had two sons. And now the son that's known as the prodigal son is the one who left home. And so again, the lyrics start, and I want you to just hear this as God saying it to you. So he says, I know you're going, and I can't make you stay. It's just not who he is. He's not going to force you to be close to him. He's not going to force you to stay with him. Anytime you're in a relationship where somebody's trying to force you to be with them or force you to be close to them, it's manipulation. And if the person doesn't want to be close to you, it's because they obviously don't see the value that you feel like you have. And so if they don't see the value in the relationship, why try to make them be somewhere they don't want to be? And so he said, I can't make you stay. I will only let you know that I love you anyway. And if the road you take leads to heartbreak somewhere down the line, if someone ever hurts you or treats your heart unkind, it's a cold world out here. And a lot of times we leave and we think we're going to find something better. And a lot of times we need to leave. We need to walk away. You know, but when you see what it's like on the other side, you know, there's a quote, the grass is greener on the other side. And my dad used to say, well, you need to look at the water bill, you know, because it may cost you more to walk away. And so he's saying, if someone ever hurts you or treats your heart unkind, just run to the arms of the one who loves you. And what God is trying to let you know right now is that it doesn't matter how far you've gone. That doesn't matter to him. You know, when we do things that we're ashamed of, a lot of times we run away from God when we ought to run to him. He's the one that is for us. The world can be against you, but God is for you. People will leave, but God will never leave you. He'll never forsake you. He supports you. He encourages you. He wants the best for you. And so he's saying, just come back. You know, his you're never too far where his arm can't reach you. And so he said, just run to the arms of the one who loves you. Just run to these arms, and these two arms will keep you warm. When rain has failed your heart, never fear, he's never far. Just run to the arms of the one who loves you. He is going to be right where you left him. He will pick up with you right where you all left off. So then moving to the next verse, it says, I want you happy. I want the best for you. And that is how God feels. There are amazing plans and purposes that have been in the heart and the mind of God for you in the beginning. And he desperately wants to share those things with you. And you know, he likes to kind of play this almost hide and seek kind of game, where it's in his glory that he will conceal a thing, because he's wanting you in your glory to come to seek it out. You know, Jesus said, he told the people to ask, to seek, and to knock. And that's present participle, meaning ask and keep asking. Seek and keep seeking. Knock and keep knocking, because there's always more to unfold. There's always this great revealing of what has been planned, these beautiful plans and purposes for your life that have been designed, that have been set up for you to prosper you, to give you a hope and a future. And so, I want you happy. I want the best for you. This is what God is saying to you. And if you have to leave to find your dream, I hope that dream comes true. You know, when the prodigal son wanted to leave, the dad didn't try to make him stay. The dad wanted the best for him. And God wants the best for you. He cares so much about you, it's nothing he wouldn't do for you. He didn't even spare his own son, but gave him up freely. And so now, how much more will he not, along with the son, give you all things? And so it says, but if the world you find brings you hard times, if someone makes you cry, I'll be there to hold you. I'll be standing by. With the prodigal son, he went out and he did his thing. He was searching, and he didn't find what he was looking for. And he had this epiphany, this revelation that, oh, wow, I need to go back home. Even at the very least, if I can just be like a servant for my dad, then, you know, hired help or something. I mean, even the hired help are doing better than what I'm doing out here on my own. And so, unsure of how the dad would receive him, you know, he decided to turn back. And the scripture says that while he was a ways off, because notice here it says, I'll be there to hold you, I'll be standing by. The scripture says when the son was a ways away, the dad saw him. The dad had been waiting for the son to come home. The dad had been anticipating the son's return. When the son was a ways off, the father saw him and ran out to the son, ran out to meet him. And then he wraps his arms around the son. And of course, the son isn't expecting this, you know. And the dad wraps his arms around the son, because like the song is saying, this is the one who loves you. And that's the thing, when it's really love, it's not contingent on stuff. It's not based on how well you're doing. It's not even based on what you do. It's solely based on who the person is. How somebody loves you is a reflection of who they are, not who you are. And the way God loves is a reflection of who he is. Not a reflection of who we are. Not a reflection of what we've done or what we could ever do. And the dad wraps his arms around him. And, you know, he gives him the best things. These things that he had for him all along. You know, he puts a ring on his finger, the best ring, and the best robe and shoes on his feet. And here the boy is thinking he's going to come back and, you know, be like the hired help. But the dad is like, no, this is who you are. This is who you are. This is how I feel about you.
Okay, so I want to minister this to you in song. And as I do it, I want you to hear God singing this over you. Hear him sharing his heart for you through this song, because he loves to sing over you. He rejoices over you with singing. And so he's saying, he knows you're going and he won't make you stay. He will only let you know he'll love you anyway. And if the road you find leads to heartbreak somewhere down the line, if someone ever hurts you or treats you hard unkind, just run to the arms of the one who loves you. Just run